Project Vortex opened the first dimensional gate, we didn't know what to expect. The last thing we thought we would find was that we were already expected. The Necron were as blind to humanity's existence as we were to theirs. But they had already possessed dimensional technology for some time. They understood it better, and used it to destroy other worlds, enslave races, and consume entire civilizations. It's possible the Necron may never have calculated Earth's existence, never known where to look. But when the Vortex experiments began stretching the dimensional fabric, the Necron took notice. They drew plans. They gathered their forces. And when we opened the gate, the Necron came through.
Dimensional node selector activated. Stand by to launch. Five, four, three, two, one, launch.
Thank you. Well done, Eugene. You successfully destroyed the Necron Converter in the Temple Wasteland Dimension. It was a dangerous mission to attack and destroy the desert stronghold, but you pulled it off. You've saved millions of lives with your heroic act. Now, countless Necron warriors won't be able to enter Earth from the barren dimension. Even better, rebel forces on ravaged Earth will have less to fear from the Necron's air power. Humans won't worry about more air raids from Necron assault hovercrafts. Many people can't remember a single day when those flying machines didn't threaten their lives.
Dimensional node selector activated. Stand by to launch. Five, four, three, two, one, launch.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
Congratulations, Eugene. I've intercepted an encrypted Necron broadcast stating the monstrous building, the Citadel's gone. You've closed the window between Earth and the Darkland dimension by destroying the Necron converter. You're the first to succeed in penetrating the Citadel's deadly maze of tunnels. This is great news for the forces on ravaged Earth. The Rebellion is turning the table on the Necron. With the once impenetrable Necron military headquarters gone, the Necron won't have a central strategic planning center to organize their attack against us. We've made great inroads in the fight for freedom.
Dimensional node selector activated. Stand by to launch. Five, four, three, two, one, launch.
Thank you.
successful mission, Eugene. The Earth's oceans will be safer. You've destroyed the Necron Converter and the naval plant in the Ice Nest Dimension. It was a crucial victory, and your success means humans can now better defend the high seas. It wasn't easy to fight on the cold, icy naval station. But now the Necron will lose control of the Earth's waters. The Rebels know the Necron can't depend on naval supplies to come from that dimension. The Rebels on ravaged Earth will now have an easier time defending Earth's coastlines.
Dimensional node selector activated. Stand by to launch. Five, four, three, two, one, launch.
Thank you.
Mission accomplished, Eugene. By destroying the Necron converter in the Red Fort's dimension, you've cut off the Necron's ground supply of tanks and troop transporters. You took on the Necron armored bikes and defeated them. Your mission was crucial for the rebellion. You destroyed the Necron's endless supply of deadly ground assault vehicles. They've taken a major toll on our people. The rebel forces on ravaged Earth are now more secure about their ability to overcome the Necron, because their machinery will be left to rot in the desert sun.
Dimensional node selector activated. Stand by to launch. Five, four, three, two, one, launch.
Thank you.
Success, Eugene. You've devastated the Necron's mining operation. They won't be able to deliver raw materials from the Moon Core dimension to manufacturing plants in other dimensions. This is a major blow to the Necron's military defenses. They'll be forced to rely on what machinery and weaponry they already have. Now that Moon Core's crucial mining is cut off, it'll be easier to fight them. The rebels on ravaged Earth can soon rely on the Necron running out of weapons. Just remember, there are rumors out there that the rebellion is weakening. You know that's not true. We are gaining strength. The rebel forces are behind you and are fighting to destroy the Necron.
We'll be right back. Vortex systems activated. Please clear the gantry area. Dimensional node selector activated. Stand by to launch. Five, four, three, two, one, launch.
Great job, Eugene. The dreaded Necron torture chamber is destroyed, and the gateway to the Death Cloud dimension is closed. Destroying the Necron converter stops the enemy from taking humans from Earth and turning them into slaves on Death Cloud. Thanks to you, thousands of captured people won't have to face the hideous conversion process that awaited them there. Now, without slaves to operate their mining facilities, the Necron will lose power. They'll have to rely on their own warriors to work the mines and manufacturing facilities, leaving less of them to fight the war.
Thank you. PFC Eugene Jenkins. Rebel forces all over the world continue to fight cells of resistance. But with the Necron forces weakened and the Rebel forces advancing toward the capital, we expect surrender of the master.
It's over now. Our homes are liberated and our lands are secure. But it's only the present that's safe, never the future. We have tasted the knowledge of a greater universe, and we've only begun to pay the price for that knowledge. We cannot return to our lives in that childish innocence that we once had. We cannot pretend that the Necron never came here, or that they never will again. Now, as adults, we know that there are monsters under the bed, and that shape in the dark of the closet isn't just a coat. The Necron know we are here, and when they reopen the gate, they will be back.